Welcome to Mojo Plays, and today we're counting down our picks for the 10 locations in Hogwarts Legacy everyone missed. For this list, we'll be looking at those unassuming, secret, overlooked, or otherwise easily missed locations that Revelio might not always help with. Hogwarts Legacy provides a sheer cornucopia of magical locations to discover, many off the beaten path. So be sure to cozy up with this video and have your wands at the ready to let us know in the comment section which easily missed locations you stumbled across or sought out in Hogwarts Legacy's delightfully explorable world of magic, whimsy, and all things fantastical. Before we begin, we publish new content all week long, so be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos. Quill of Acceptance and Book of Admittance Room. This tiny, out-of-the-way room is likely the most important location in all of Hogwarts Castle. Why, you might ask? It's because the Quill of Acceptance and its scrawlings in the Book of Admittance records every single person that has some sort of magical attunement. Essentially, this sentient quill and book track any source of magic in people, from the most basic forms to the powerful ancient magic displayed in Hogwarts Legacy's player-controlled witch or wizard. These two magical instruments decide who gets to immerse themselves in Hogwarts' curriculum. The room itself isn't the easiest to find since it lies all the way up near the headmaster's quarters, an area most players won't naturally get to unless they are following along Sebastian's Slytherin Scriptorium quest. Alliteration aside, this room, which was placed by the Hogwarts founders themselves, feels utterly unique, with the Quill of Acceptance and the Book of Admittance in the center, surrounded by the glow of dripping candles. Oh, and you can only gain access with the well-hidden Key of Admittance located in the Headmaster's private tower room. Headmaster's private tower room. Speaking of the Headmaster's private tower room, this cozy and elegant room won't be easy to get to, with many players probably missing out on it completely. Locked behind an Alohomora level 3 lock side door in the headmaster's office, this room is accessed via a winding set of outside stairs that lead up to the titular tower spire. You are first greeted with a mesmerizing view of the surrounding landscape, including bucolic green rolling hills, the vastness of the Black Lake below, and off in the distance, Hogsmeade and Hogsmeade Station. Prying yourself away from this view isn't easy, but for those that do, entering the balcony door greets you with a small room that feels quite large given its vaulted, spired ceiling and celestial wallpaper. This is one of those locations in the game that is completely optional, but for fans of scouring every nook and cranny of Hogwarts Castle, it's an absolute must-find. From the roaring fire to the mounds of well-read books to the large ornate windows, this private tower room should be on your Hogwarts Legacy travel guide. Plus, if you want to get to the aforementioned Quill and Book Room, you need to first come here to gain the Key of Admittance, located on the Headmaster's messy desk. Stitches and Drafts Shop, Haunted Hogsmeade Shop. For those that own the PlayStation versions of Hogwarts Legacy, there is, for better or worse, an exclusive, and might I add, delightfully spooky side questline that sees you explore a seemingly abandoned and derelict shop in Hogsmeade. By starting the Minding Your Own Business side quest in the Charming Hamlet, you are greeted to the house elf Penny and the witch Cassandra Mason. By taking on this quest after speaking with them, you are meant to just head into a basement to acquire Cassandra's now deceased husband's belongings. But let's not forget that before that, you need to first cop off 1500 gold for the luxury of buying the shop outright. So as to avoid many of the surprises this quest has to offer, you essentially complete a set of nefarious tasks laid out by the zany ghost known as Fastidio the Poltergeist. Upon completion of this part of the quest, the shop is now yours to own, with Penny being your loyal companion and shopkeeper, should you wish. You are given a choice of shop names, with mine being Stitches and Drafts, and it's then that the shop's exterior receives an overhaul with the new name added to the signage. Okay, so the actual interior of the shop consistently and permanently remains messy and in disarray throughout the remainder of the game, but there is still a sense of whimsy, with the magical MacGuffins scattered and strewn all about the place. The vibe of your newly acquired shop fits in perfectly with the Hogsmeade feel. Plus, you can return to Penny at any time to sell any items you don't want to keep with you anymore. upon Ford. Pit upon Ford is one of those locations in Hogwarts Legacy that so many players missed because it lies at the very tippy top of the world map, deep in the heart of the woodlands just outside of the Forbidden Forest. However, to miss this utterly breathtaking village would be a massive mistake, given how lush, gorgeous, and quaint it is. According to the in-game map info, Pit upon Ford means placed by a shallow river. Now, this description is frankly quite reductive, given how magnificent it is to explore and wander through, but it is indeed by a river, unfortunately one filled with dug bogs that really aren't happy you're around. Regardless of the dug bog threat, the villagers of Pit upon Ford don't seem bothered at all. As you stroll around the pathway, you will find verdant flora and fauna, spectacular colors, cozy, well-lived-in houses, a small village square with a shopkeeper, and plenty of cute cats that you can stop and pet. But why is it that the cats' meows in this game sound a bit terrifying? Anyway, stopping to look around, you will even notice a gushing waterfall with a castle spire high above on the hilltop. The game never pulls you here on its own, so be sure to seek it out right away. Perhaps one of the villagers could even set up an Airbnb here. That would be splendid. Secret Underbridge Passage. To be right up front with all of you, this location that everyone missed isn't so much of a top-tier exciting location to explore, but is instead one brimming with mystery, since it's so close to get to, but just out of reach. One of the main connecting bridges in Hogwarts Castle hides a secret passage just below it. Walking across this bridge greets you with a set of four fire sconces, two on each end of the bridge. Interestingly, they aren't lit, which, as many Hogwarts Legacy players know all too well, means they likely have to do with a puzzle using Incendia or Confringo. But setting each of these ablaze doesn't do anything on its own. By turning the fire sconces using a special ornate floor grate as a guide, the secret is eventually revealed, with the grate sliding open to reveal a ladder guiding you down to the passageway below. What lies beneath is a lower level of the bridge with a stream of water running through it, somewhat like a mini aqueduct. There are a handful of top-notch treasure chests down here which help you acquire some great loot. While not an outwardly stunning location, solving the puzzle to get down here makes you feel like you are the first one to discover it. The Pond with a View. Understated and overlooked are the best two words to describe this unnamed location near the outskirts of the Forbidden Forest. I have lovingly named this location The Pond with a View because it's an apt description for an otherwise benign location in the game. Now, there's a chance some players could happen upon this boggy pond area near a small poacher camp if the Poppy Sweeting relationship questline is followed. But for those that skip out on it, which you shouldn't by the way, then it's unlikely you will get here of your own volition. This somewhat dark and dank area of the woodlands has a small pond with a dug bog battle. In the center of the pond, on a small plot of land, is a hidden treasure chest as well. While the poacher camp has some loot, you should really stop by this location because of the view when walking out. Walking out of this location moves you between two cliff walls along a pathway. You are then greeted by an incredible view of Hogwarts Castle in the distance with the Forbidden Forest in the foreground. Now, depending on the time of day, this vista will surely provide you with plenty of screenshot-worthy moments and surely shows the artistry of this game on display. The Tilted House. Like something straight out of Alice in Wonderland, the Tilted House is a unique anomaly in an otherwise simple and quaint village, namely that of Keenbridge. Located in the heart of the Hogwarts Valley region, Keenbridge itself is a wonderful location to discover, either organically or through a relationship quest or two. Like many villages in the game, there are NPCs to chat with, a shopkeeper to interact with, a Merlin trial to complete, and plenty of locked houses to use your Alohomora skills on. However, it's the unassuming, oddly shaped house near the village road that deserves your time and attention. The aptly named Tilted House is just that, a small cottage that has been warped and augmented due to the gargantuan tree that grows through it and around it. Stepping into the house, you are greeted with the warm glow of the candles and fireplace. Walking around inside can make you feel a bit wonky given its tilted nature, especially with vines and roots jutting up through the floorboards. It's a fun location to discover and one that should be on your travel map right away. South Clagmar Coast. Ah yes, the calm and serene coastal region of Hogwarts Legacy. Most players won't be heading to the higher level coastal region until much, much later in the game, once the main quest dives even deeper into Ranrok's mines and drilling sites. Sure, you can head to this out of the way region earlier, but to do so might mean you're missing out on the hidden locations in and around the Hogsmeade and Hogwarts Valley areas. However, once you do venture to the coastal region, it's of the utmost importance to specifically seek out South Clagmar Coast. While there aren't many grounded activities here to complete, it's one of those locations brimming with rugged beauty. South Clagmar Coast does feature a couple of side quests, but it's not the main reason to head here. The reason to do so is to take in the breathtaking views, the salty air, the rundown cottages, and the wildlife. There's actually a Flupowder fast travel location in a small oceanside hut where a humble NPC seemingly lives and spends his time. With a broken down pier, a simple Merlin trial, the skeletal remains of a large beast, and even a poacher-filled castle ruin to explore, South Clagmar Coast is certainly on the outskirts, but provides a distinct and sublime beauty not seen in the more traditional Hogwarts and Hogsmeade areas. Just be sure to pack your rain jacket since it's quite a bit more damp and wet here.
Your poaching days are over.
Dilapidated Mansion Crypt. Flying on your broomstick with the dilapidated mansion in the distance is quite the spectacle. With the sun rising, the ocean waves swelling, and the sound of the wind rushing by you, it's quite special to see this creepy-looking location getting closer to you. As you get closer to this mansion and its surrounding grounds, which have somehow been kept up quite well, you know you're in for something spooky and mysterious. Specifically, this location houses a crypt, one that can only be accessed at the top of a cliff, with Incendio or Confringo being your key to set ablaze the sconce that sits in your way. Upon doing so, you can head on down to the crypt itself. This dilapidated mansion crypt actually houses a secret side quest via a note and a treasure map. But getting to the goods means you have to contend with some ferocious Inferi and Inferius. Weakened by fire spells, these baddies put up quite the fight. However, it's worth the battle and exploration since this derelict crypt feels haunting and creepy. A real treat for those of us with a penchant for all things horror. Candles and torches adorn the halls and walls of this location. Should you persist in your exploration, you eventually make your way inside the foreboding dilapidated mansion itself. Honeydukes' Cellar. You might think I'm bonkers for adding a humble shop cellar to this list. However, hear me out. To get to Honeydukes' Cellar, you first need to accept Gareth Weasley's relationship quest, Descending for Sweets, about breaking into the candy factory that is Honeydukes via a secret passageway from the one-eyed witch statue in Hogwarts Castle. Now that may sound simple, but keep in mind, many of us, myself included, wanted to play through the game as a goody-two-shoes witch or wizard. So the idea of breaking into the delightful sugar-drenched Hogsmeade shop seemed like blasphemy. Heck, I didn't even learn any of the curses from Sebastian since that might mean leaning towards the dark side. With that being said, I did eventually break into Honeydukes' cellar via the secret passageway in order to steal some Billywig stings for Gareth's new butterbeer concoction. Getting to the cellar isn't the easiest task, but once you do arrive there, you can now see the underbelly of the Sweets Emporium. It's actually quite the dichotomy seeing the dark and dank cellar where stock is stored in comparison to the color, candy, and sugar overload of the shop above. It's a location you shouldn't miss because there's something special about knowing you can get there easily from your common room should you desire a midnight snack or treat. Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from Mojo Plays and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.